direction since then, and we are honored to invite him today. Paul's a graduate of Wheeling Jesuit University with a BA in International Studies. He studied politics in the Middle East at the University of Aleppo, am I pronouncing it right? In Aleppo, Syria, in the summer of 2000. He served a one-year tour of duty with the U.S. Army in Iraq from 2003 to 2004 as a combat engineer during the invasion. Since that time, he's also graduated from the University of Pittsburgh's Graduate School of Public and International Affairs. During the course of his graduate experience, he returned to Damascus, Syria, to conduct research on the effect of the war in Iraq on internal Syrian identity politics. And currently, Paul is a seminarian at St. Tikhon's? Tikhon's, sorry. Orthodox Theological Seminary, and an active member of Iraq Veterans Against the War. I'll leave it at that. So let's welcome Paul Abernathy.
Good afternoon. It's really good to be here with all of you. I've heard so many wonderful things about everything that you all have been doing in this area, and it gives me great joy, to the deepest part of my heart, to know that this is happening, because this war must end. It must be ended at a local level. I know that. I know that's the way our country functions. And so no matter what we do, no matter how small an area it seems we're working in, it's making a much larger impact than we imagine. So for that, I am very grateful to all of you who are working in the anti-war movement. I also want to apologize to you if I may be a little rusty. I haven't done this since August. I have some notes under the chair. I prefer not to use them. Since I've been in seminary, my mind's been filled with other things, as you can imagine. So hopefully this goes pretty well. So bear with me. If I need to take a pause. The anti-war movement has often been accused of being against GIs. I've heard it time and time again. Fox News or right-wing propagandists, they love to say that the anti-war movement is against GIs. But quite frankly, this ignores the reality of the situation in the United States military. Iraq Veterans Against the War, a lot of people think of as an organization. And officially it is. We have paperwork, bylaws, officers, organizational structure. But because we're working with soldiers, not every soldier can be on the books, if you know what I'm saying. Because the consequences for being involved in the anti-war movement are kind of extreme sometimes in the military. Camilo Mejia went to prison because he didn't believe in this. And depending on where soldiers are in their personal place in life, depends on how far they feel that they can come to do that. So our numbers officially are about 600, but believe me, this goes well beyond an organization. It transcends an organization. It is a movement. And it reaches the deepest parts of every branch in the United States military. Because every action that Iraq Veterans Against the War does, we find ourselves surrounded by other members of the military who are not officially members of Iraq Veterans Against the War, but put past themselves off as Iraq Veterans Against the War. Because it isn't an organization, it's a movement of GIs who are stepping forward and taking action against this war in many different ways. We have the appeal for redress. You have 2,104 service members have signed that. I just gave you the numbers of Iraq Veterans Against the War. Veterans are in the forefront of every anti-war action, every major anti-war action that's been happening in the country. Not this past year, not last year, the year before that. This has been going on strong since 2004, but strong for the past 3 years. This is not a joke. There are, according to the Pentagon, 40,000 soldiers who are AWOL, or deserters. since September 11, 2001. And believe me, most of it is because of the Iraq War. Soldiers in the military who cannot outrightly speak against the war without fear of retribution have devised small ways to go undetected by their superiors to demonstrate their anti-war sentiments with one another. Many of you, I'm sure, are familiar with the internet and know that blogging has become a popular hobby for soldiers dissatisfied with this war, with this regime, with the leaders that they have given us to lead us in combat. All of these things are readily available, and I think we need to ask ourselves as a people why this isn't in the front page of our newspaper more. This is the great untold story of this war. And one of the things I would charge you all with is to make this story more known. Now, Iraq Veterans Against the War has engaged in several actions. Matthew spoke about Operation First Casualty, which of course, as he said, we enacted some of the things that we did in Iraq, not that we heard about, but that we did in Iraq. They weren't just experiences that we sat down and said, hey, how should we put together this theater? It wasn't like that. Because whenever we were planning on how to do this, guys were saying, well, one time we did it like this, or the squad next to me used this strategy, so why don't we do it this way? Because it's easier for all of us to learn because we learn from different people. We did the same stuff, but slightly different ways. It was a conversation of personal experience. It wasn't theatrical.